Hey, Tara? Tara?
Yes?
Can you put me up for the night? Oh! I did it! I went there! Yes!
Wake up, Bridget. It's an emergency.
I've been waiting for 2 hours to do that shit.
You're the only one cute enough to save us now. He's gone and see. Hi, Nash. Look how cute I am. Hi. It'll all be okay. It's all gonna be okay. We've got a kitty. Everything's okay. She's a little grumpy because I just woke her up.
Hairy baby.
She's a little grumpy because I literally just woke her up. Like, she was all curled up and happy and sleeping there.
Like, bitch, why you gotta do that?
And then I was like, hey, wake up. And she's like, no.
She's like, that ain't cool. That ain't cool, man.
I was comfy. Bridget got in an awful lot of trouble tonight. Bridget almost got skinned. Do you want to tell them what you did? Do you want to tell them what a bad kitty you were today?
What did the bad kitty do?
My nephew goes to Catholic school, so they do a lot of community outreach stuff. So one of his classmates, his father's having some kind of surgery this week. He's okay, but he's having surgery. So one of the things all the families do is they've set up a rotation calendar. Like if a family member is sick or someone dies, and everyone brings food on a different night of the week.
That is a weirdly American Judeo-Christian thing we do. It's like if something bad happens, out come the casseroles.
Yeah. So my sister made this like chicken and broccoli casserole that she makes.
See?
Yeah. And had it out on the counter, was getting it prepped or something, and turns around and sees that Bridget has pilfered 2 pieces of chicken from the casserole that is to be donated to a family in need.
Well, she's in need.
And Bridget almost got skinned tonight.
She's in need. She needs.
I heard my sister down the hall say, "I am literally going to kill you." They're all like, "Uh-oh, what did Bridget do?"
She's a kitty. She's in need. She needs chicken.
She's so mad right now. She's like, "Why am I awake? I was so comfy. Why you do this?"
Does she have to remake the entire casserole or is she doing the "we'll just not mention the cat" part to the neighbors?
I think she remade the whole thing. She's a dietitian and a food scientist. She can't let that stand.
Does that mean
this aggression will not stand? So Bridget has been in the doghouse all night. So now she's hiding in my room because she's been in trouble.
Well,
my sister actually came into my room and was like, "I just want to let you know, Bridget is to get no treats tonight. I don't want anyone petting her. Do not be nice to Bridget. She was very bad." And I'm like, and she's like holding the cat. Like,
does that mean
bringing the cat on the walk of shame around the house, telling everyone not to be nice to her?
Wait, because she made a whole new casserole. Why can't Bridget have the other one? I mean, who else is going to eat it?
We are. We're going to eat it. So we get chicken casserole tomorrow. Because you were very bad. Oh, you're so mad at me. You're like, "Let me go back to sleep, you crazy bitch. I'm tired. I got important kitty stuff to do. I need my beauty sleep."
And I also saw where she discovered the laser pointer for the first time.
Mm-hmm.
You put that on your Facebook.
Well, that wasn't the first time. My nephew has a Nerf gun with a laser pointer on it. So, all right. Go
fuck off!
If you're going to be grumpy about it.
Get the fuck off me!
So one of the games they play is my nephew shoots the Nerf darts and she chases them. Well, he has one Nerf gun that has a laser sight on it. And that's even better.
Okay, so I guess the subtitle for this week should be "I'm 12. Is pretty much what we're going to be going with tonight, because I don't see anything other way of putting it. But let's get the intro going. Each week, Catherine, the Radio Dead Air audience, go out in the worldwide interwebs, fight all sorts of horrible stuff, bring it back here for a little segment we like to call "What the Fuck Is Wrong With You?" And I could do nothing else.
She actually left the room. I made her really mad. She's like, "Hell with you. I'm out of here."
when I read this headline, I could do nothing else but giggle. I swear that there was stuff going on playing in the background. You guys didn't know. I was playing sets and whatnot, and then meanwhile, I was just sitting here dying. Stop looking at it again, and it's doing it to me again.
Is it monkeys? It's monkeys, isn't it?
No.
If you're this happy, it's monkeys.
It's not monkeys.
There's only one thing that makes you this happy.
No, there's another thing. I'm sorry. This is gross, but yet kind of amazing.
Oh God!
Exploding poop topples building in China.
This pleased you? This made you happy?
It's exploding poop. It knocked a building over.
Brought you joy.
It knocked a building over.
Well, that's pretty much a metaphor for modern existence. Our own shit is just crumbling civilization around us.
The blast has apparently been sparked by a local man burning waste close to a cesspool. This is in Beijing. A cesspool filled with excrement has exploded in central China, injuring 15 and knocking down a building. Nobody died. Everything's fine. The blast was apparently sparked by a local man burning waste close to the cesspool, igniting methane gas, which was emanating from the pit. The incident happened in Zhangwei. Xinhua.
Xinhua.
Wow.
You don't know that?
All deference.
That's like their top news agency.
I don't know. I'm a white man. I'm a white, middle class, over 30 American.
So am I.
Yeah, but you're not a guy.
Well, actually, I'm probably poorer than you.
Yeah, but you're not a guy. We don't know things. We're idiots.
Well, I actually had to explain to my boyfriend today what the proper abbreviation for shampoo is. That it's poo related.
China's urban infrastructure has been hastily built with little regard for safety as hundreds of millions have moved from the countryside to the city in recent decades. I'm just trying to picture how big this cesspool was to knock down a building.
Well, how big was the building?
That's a lot of poop.
How big was the building?
You know, I don't even care if that was a garden shed. That's still a lot of poop. To knock that shit over. Well, to knock the building over. The shit.
All I can think of now is the Simpsons movie. Tell me you saw the Simpsons
movie. I did. It's just been a while.
The poop silo for Spider Pig?
Ah, yes.
Set off the whole chain of events. The whole chain of events was set off by pig poop.
Well, this was set off by people poop.
And I'm telling you, we are literally and metaphorically just being dismantled by our own shit.
Speaking of being set off by poop, and you say no, we're being taken apart by our own shit.
Yes,
the UK would.
Oh, I mean, as a species.
Well, the UK would beg to differ because they've come up with a brand new innovation in poop. United Kingdom's first poo bus hits the road. Britain's first bus powered entirely by human and food waste take the streets between Bath and Bristol. Britain's first poo bus will take to the road on Thursday. The 40-seat bio bus runs on biomethane gas generated through treatment of sewage and food waste. It can travel up to 186 miles on one tank of gas, which takes the annual waste of around 5 people to produce.
You know, I love this idea because it's the only thing we're not running out of.
However,
we are always going to poop more, but that smell.
Exactly. Who is lining up at the bus stop going, you know, I can take the diesel bus, but today it's a poop bus.
There was a guy a few years ago, a lot of the news agencies covered. He had built a car that would run on basically used cooking grease. And he would go around to diners and collect their used cooking grease, and his car would run on that. And his neighbor said that smell was unbearable, like the used French fry grease, basically. So actual burning shit.
Rock and Roll Martian wins the chat. He says, when this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're going to see some serious shit.
Oh, hi. Am I forgiven? Oh, you had a snack. You can tell when she's had a snack because she comes in home. Right, baby? Last night, she got a piece of my hair in her mouth and just sat there. I couldn't figure out why she was just licking the air. She was like, and then finally, I saw a piece of red hair hanging out of her mouth. And I'm like, well, that's just fair.
Okay, J.M. Shearer said, so that's the UK's Grand Pooh Bus. That was awful. That was awful.
You play Got Your Toes all day. I'm sorry. I'm distracted by the kitty. And then she gnaws on my arm for half an hour.
I just, that is.
I mean, I love the idea. If it doesn't smell like the pit of hell, everybody poops. We're always going to poop.
On the other hand,
we're never going to run out of that resource because we are so full of shit.
On the other hand, you will never not know when the bus is coming. When's the bus going to get here? About 2 minutes.
She doesn't know. She's like, do I want to sleep or do I want to attack you? I don't know. I haven't decided. Well, in the future, when we're all living on like nutrition pellets, they can just scent them so that this will work beautifully. Oh, come here, baby.
I cannot imagine. You don't want to fill the tank. No one wants to fill the tank. No one wants to be the guy to fill that tank.
No. Because if this takes off, all of our cars are going to run on poop someday. But think about it. That'll be the end of gas stations. You just go out to the tank, to the septic in your backyard. You never run out of gas on the highway. You just stop and poop into your tank.
Can't I just use a fuel cell like a normal hipster?
Really? We're sitting like this? Look at this. She's like, love me.
She's Garbo. So we're not done with poo yet. Well, okay, we are, but I
can could... Is this poop week?
Well, no, this technically isn't. I couldn't resist it because we had poop and we had poo and now we have poo again, but it's a different poo.
They have a poo emoji lapel pin. I'm going to buy it for you.
Polish town bans Winnie the Pooh for not wearing pants. Winnie the Pooh may be loved by children everywhere, but the willy-nilly silly old stuffed bear with fluff has caused quite a huff in a Polish community. You know, whoever wrote that sentence took great pleasure in constructing this for a serious news article. They loved doing that shit.
Donald Duck doesn't wear pants either.
Counselors in the town of Susan have punted Pooh as a possible playground patron because of his dubious sexuality and inappropriate dress.
Winnie the Pooh doesn't have a sexuality. He's a teddy bear.
One of the city councils is quoted as saying, the problem with that bear is it doesn't have a complete wardrobe. It is half naked, which is wholly inappropriate for children.
It's bear.
The unnamed counselor denounced Pooh as a hermaphrodite.
Are we at this point? Is this where we are?
Although the counselor may have meant the bear was androgynous. Okay, so the man himself doesn't know the right word. The newspaper reporter had to interpret for him.
Winnie the Pooh is one of the few things left in the world that is good and pure and unsullied. And we're fucking it up.
Because we have to put pants on him.
Well, that does remind me of a joke.
Oh, God.
So the teacher asks kids, you know, what they did over the weekend. Did they do their reading assignment? Blah, blah, blah. It's like a first grade class. And the first kid says, well, my mommy and my daddy took me to my granny's house, blah, 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 blah. And the teacher says, no, 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 Jimmy, use your big boy words. It's not, you know, mommy and daddy and Nana. He says, well, my mother and my father took me to grandpa's, blah, 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 blah. And they move on. And she keeps correcting the kids. No, 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 use your grown-up words. One of the kids raises his hand and says, I have to go wee wee. No, no, you have to go to the bathroom. So finally she gets around to the last kid. And she says, so what did you do this weekend? And he said, well, I did some reading. She said, oh, okay, well, that's great. What did you read? Winnie the Shit. I know I just gave a big speech about how Winnie the Pooh was innocent and unsullied, and then I...
Sullied in Winnie the Pooh. You have sullied Winnie the Pooh.
Hey, clearly I wasn't the first.
All right. You know, I understand.
Let's just not think about whether Winnie the Pooh, what tackle Winnie the Pooh has. Can we just agree as a species on that? Let's not think about what's between Winnie the Pooh's legs.
Terry, you say that, and immediately everyone who just heard that is now involuntarily thinking about what's between Winnie the Pooh's legs.
Can we just, as a species, agree to leave that alone?
I understand they have to be concerned about kids. That's fine. I don't have any, but you want to be concerned about them, that's fine. But would it have been better if he just not wore a shirt? If they didn't wear anything?
Tigger walks around naked.
I know!
What?
So now we've Winnie the Shit and Tigger the Slut.
Piglet? I guess Piglet wears a really long shirt.
I don't know what Piglet wears, though.
It's like, oh no, he has like a bathing suit thing, doesn't he?
Because it looks like a beet or something. I don't know what, he looks weird.
He has like a unitard. Now that I think about it, it's really weird. He wears like a girl's bathing suit, but I don't think he's a girl character.
I don't know what I don't think Piglet knows what Piglet is.
It's like a onesie. Why does Piglet wear, I guess Piglet is a child, but we're overthinking it.
A little bit.
But most of those characters are naked, is my point.
So we talked a little bit last week about Southern stereotypes and stuff, about the cowboy boots and all that stuff. Tara, I have found you. There is none more Southern than what you're about to see. This is pretty much...
You're going to get me in a lot of trouble because I'm going to say some things. Last week, I got a bit of a talking to.
This is peak redneck, what I'm about to show you here, okay? None more redneck. None more.
And Eeyore walks around with a glorified butt plug, for God's sake.
What do you want for your birthday, Eeyore? Thumbs and a gun, Pooh. Thumbs and a gun. Anyway, none more redneck. Drunk man drives tractor to South Alabama store for more beer, gets arrested. A shirtless, intoxicated man was arrested Wednesday after he drove a tractor to a local store for more beer. Covington County Sheriff's Department says 37-year-old Robbie Price, a resident of Grange Forge Road, drove the tractor more than 6 miles to a Dollar General store with the intent of buying more alcohol. Yes, I know.
Don't buy beer at the dollar store.
I told you.
Don't buy beer at the dollar. You know, everything, every food stuff at the dollar store is like teetering on the edge of poison because it's so expired. Or like just at the point where they can still legally sell it. That's how it gets to the dollar store. Don't buy beer at the dollar store.
This is, let's see. He's shirtless. He's drunk. He's in Alabama driving a tractor to the dollar store for beer. None more redneck.
I mean, I suppose if his name was like Buford.
It's Bobby!
It's Bobby Lee.
It's Bobby! It's but Bobby Lee Price!
Bobby Lee.
Bobby Lee! His
Bobby
name
Lee
is
Price,
Bobby
what you
Lee.
You got yourself into this time. Ain't I told you Bobby Lee to stay out of trouble?
Oh, okay. Emma mentioned, did he have a Confederate flag on the tractor? That, it doesn't say, but that would have been the pièce de résistance.
Hmm.
This is magical.
Well, did he have a gun? Doesn't say he had a gun.
No.
As far as I understand it, pretty much everybody south of the Mason-Dixon line, it's like required that you own about 62 guns.
Smapty says, it was about this point them Duke boys realized they was in a heap of trouble.
Dan would like to point out to you all that he does not buy his beer at the dollar store. He buys it at the Piggly Wiggly.
You know, I actually miss having Piggly Wiggly just for the reaction of explaining to people we're going to the Piggly Wiggly, and they have no idea what the fuck the Piggly Wiggly is, but it sounds wrong. So they just get this look in their eyes like, what's the Piggly Wiggly?
Because like, it could go either way. That could be like convenience store
or strip club.
Strip bar.
Yeah, you know.
But not the good kind of strip club. Like
no!
The kind of strip club where
the bad
where,
strip
like,
club.
Your aunt with the cigarette burns on her stomach dances.
You know, back in when I was in middle school, they had the Piggly Wiggly had bumper stickers that said, I'm sticking with the pig. Okay, try and picture in your head the layout is I'm sticking with the pig. The people in high school figured out that if you take the bumper sticker,
stick the piggy,
and fold it over the with the, or fold it over the with, I'm sticking the pig. So that was charming. Oh, South Carolina. Anyway, that was my own little tangent there. But wait, there is a northern counterpoint to this. I guess someone saw this guy and said, you know what this meat needs? A little more Michael Bay. New Jersey man accused of stealing bulldozer for ride home. Police say a New Jersey man who was drunk stole a bulldozer in order to get a ride home. 30-year-old Christopher Russell left behind a path of destruction as he tried to maneuver the bulldozer through West Hudson Park. Bulldozer leveled signs, three benches, a tree, a drinking fountain, and left a maze in the grass.
You know, I bet they had a lot of trouble finding him.
This is one of those moments I'm amazed the heavens themselves didn't part and begin blaring yakety sax.
Those things aren't easy to drive. My father drove an excavator for many, many, many years. And those aren't easy.
And he
I mean,
was
it's
drunk.
Not the same as a bulldozer, but it's a large utility vehicle. And those are not easy.
And he did this shit while he was drunk. So that's actually a little impressive. It would have been more impressive if he hadn't smashed into everything.
How did he get the keys to a bulldozer?
Actually, you know, some construction sites, they just leave the keys in the construction vehicles.
Yeah, that's true.
And you should stop doing that! Don't leave the keys in the bulldozer!
Hello again.
Because there is always... There's always going to be some jackass who beholds this site and thinks, I could drive the bulldozer.
Really? You don't say. Can you hear her?
No.
She's
a little.
In. Well, no, she makes little noises. She talks to me. What? High five?
Just as long as she doesn't tell you to kill the neighbors, it's okay.
No, she just grumbles when I move while she's sleeping. Things like that. You know, come. And then she stares expectantly at her until I make a lap for her sit-in, because I'm very obedient.
Our last one tonight is... This is...
The whole internet is looking at your butt right now.
and she's proud of this. Last one tonight is essentially the title of our show. What the fuck is wrong with you? I feel so sorry for any woman who has to endure this kind of bullshit, because this is straight up bullshit. You already look worried. I'm sorry, but this man arrested in bizarre naked rampage at Boston Airport. Naked man falls through ceiling of airport bathroom. Authorities in Boston arrested a man who allegedly stripped naked inside a woman's restroom at Logan International Airport, climbed into a drop ceiling, crashed through, and then attacked an 84-year-old man.
Hang on here. He fell through the ceiling of a women's restroom.
Yes.
How did he come to attack an 84-year-old man in the women's
Leaving
restroom?
The restroom.
Oh, okay, because I was like, I think there's another story here.
Cameron Shank, 26, was arrested on several charges, including attempted murder, mayhem, assault, and battery on a person over 60. 84.
I like
victim.
That mayhem is a thing you can be charged with.
I want to be charged with mayhem. I really do. The 84-year-old victim was hurt, but his injuries are not life-threatening. Still, as an 84-year-old guy, what the fuck are you doing? Although, when you're 84 years old, and a naked man comes screaming out of the woman's bathroom and starts attacking you, is there really at a point where you're like, yep, now I've officially seen everything. I can die now. It's
well,
over.
Cross that one off the bucket list.
That's right. We're all done. It's time to check out.
God.
What?
My boyfriend just typed the words, at some point, I kind of want to be involved in the naked rampage.
Babuya!
I don't want you on the show like that. Like, if you want to sit next to me and make fun of people, be on the show. That's great. I don't want to have to cover your actions on the show because you didn't cover your actions.
Anyway,
that's not how I want to present you to the world.
Okay, Jed the Jedi, like the ceiling can hold us. Okay, you actually had to go there.
It was necessary. Why was he naked inside the ceiling?
This was a plan of some sort. He went to the woman's bathroom, went to the woman's bathroom, stripped down, crawled into the drop ceiling, and you know what I'm thinking this was? You know whose fault this is? Vine. This motherfucker was making a Vine, I promise you.
Oh, I thought you said mine.
No, not you.
And
Vine.
I was like, honey, I don't think we're that big.
V.
V, yes.
This guy was making a Vine.
What kind of Vine would that be? The sex offender Vine? So, look, they can see your little ears.
I'm pretty sure his plan was to get naked, pop out of the ceiling, go, hello, and, you know, 30 million views. What's Vine? Oh, honey.
I don't think that would be a very good Vine.
Most Vines you think wouldn't be a very good Vine still get 30 million views.
I mean...
Oh, wait. Emily Dash says,
was
Tara...
Was he flying somewhere?
Emily Dash says, Tara, the sex offender Vine is a thing.
Oh. Well, great. Was he flying somewhere?
I don't know.
Or is he one of the, like, do you just hang out at the airport? Are there people that do that, that just hang out at the airport when they're not going anywhere or picking someone up or dropping someone somewhere?
I don't.
I hear ads on the radio all the time that Newark International Airport has added this giant mall and they want people to come and, like, shop and hang out at the airport. And I'm like, I don't like going to the airport when I'm there for its intended purpose.
No.
Why would I go to the airport for recreation? Like, why would I go there on purpose when I don't have to? I'm not going to hang out at the fuck. It's loud. The TSA is there. People try to blow it up sometimes. I'm not hanging out there for fun.
And now naked people pop out of the restroom ceiling.
And now naked people might literally drop... Gorgeous, big-titted women don't just fall out of the sky, you know? But naked men do.
That is true. Oh my God.
Because it's happened more than once on this show. So congratulations, ladies. It's raining men. Unfortunately, they're crazy.
Oh, for fucks. Yeah, I guess that's the first thing we learned tonight. It is indeed raining men. They're just out of their fucking minds. I'm dying to know what the purpose of this was. There was some kind of plan. I mean,
I think what the plan was obvious. Helicopter dick.
Okay, it's horrific, but I just the idea of a little hole cut in the ceiling tile.
Well, I don't think you could do that laying down.
You could try. And you know what? What makes it worse?
I don't think you could do that laying on your stomach.
The worst thing is
send us videos of everybody trying.
Now in my mind, I'm just seeing a little hole cut in the ceiling, a dick dropping through, spinning around. Dun, dun, da, 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 da. I can't stop. It's making me laugh.
And then right next to it, ceiling cat is watching you helicopter dick.
We're putting too much of the internet together. We've learned that
our own shit is both killing us and saving us.
Yes.
Our own shit will either be our destruction or our salvation.
You may use the great power of poop.
Maybe both.
To create or destroy. The choice is yours.
It's like the Tesseract.
Only it's poop.
Human shit is the Tesseract.
It's the Tesseract. Only it's poop.
There is no more powerful weapon to build or to destroy.
Except
human
for
poop. Human poop is Mjolnir.
Human poop is Mjolnir.
Next time you see Thor and you get all turned on by his abs, just remember.
We've learned when it comes to cartoon bears.
Got your boy.
Chill the fuck out. It's a bear. He's not even a cartoon real bear. He's a cartoon teddy bear.
If you're going to get freaked out by something, if you're going to get freaked out by cartoon bears, maybe get freaked out by the cartoon bears that try and sell us toilet paper by making toilet paper stuck in their fur seem cute and adorable. I'm supposed to watch bright red cartoon bears wipe their butts. I don't want to watch bright cartoon bears wipe their butts. Like, that freaks me out. That whole thing is too cutesy and sweet. Let's get weird over that and leave poor Winnie the Pooh alone.
Winnie the Pooh has never been in... Winnie the Pooh does not have any concept of genitalia. If you explained it to him, he would be confused. He doesn't need pants.
And anyway, they keep getting ripped off every time he got stuck in...
Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. We just went to a dark place. We went from Winnie the Pooh doesn't have a dick to ripping Winnie the Pooh's dick off.
His little 100-acre wood would just...
Oh, Jesus Christ! Why did you do that?
I could not.
Why did you do that?
It was just there, and I had to. I'm not even sorry.
Oh, bother.